In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a tic-tac-toe game using ASP.NET MVC, C#, and Visual Studio 2022. I'll upload the code to my Patreon page and you can download it for free. This is what you will see once the application is created. So this will be like a board where you have different cells. You click on the cell and then the other player clicks on this cell, and then you will have alternately X and O. You can reset it using this and it will be back to the initial screen. So like this, you both players can play this tic-tac-toe game. Open Visual Studio 2022. Click on create a new project. Search for ASP.NET MVC. Click on this first item. Next. Give a name to your project. And then, so the project name is Tic Tac Toe in my case, so give whatever name you feel is right for you. Click on next. I will leave all these things as default. I will be using .NET 8. If you have any other versions, you can select that, or you can, you know, whatever latest version you have, you can select that. Click on create. So the project has been created. Now you can see these folders here: views, models, controllers. So I'll be creating a controller, one model, and a view to showcase how the tic-tac-toe application or the game can be developed. So first, let's start with the model. Right-click, add class. Name it as game model. Now add this code here. So let me explain the code here. So I have a constructor here called as game model, and I have three variables here at the class level, which is board, current player, and message. So the game model constructor will set certain properties. So it is basically a two-dimensional array, which will so there will be, you know, three boxes, so three columns and three rows. So that is the type of array we are creating here, a two-dimensional array. Which will hold the board basically and the values in it. So that is how you set it. You use two for loops and you set it to empty initially. So that is the initialization that will happen inside the constructor. Now there is the default message, like, you know, a player X turn, current player is X, and there is a default message. We are setting all these things in the constructor. Now we have a make move method here. We have a check win method here, and is board full. Okay, so these three methods are there. Now the make move method is public, rest two methods are private. Now these two methods are called from within this public make move method. That's why these two methods in the bottom, these are private. So the public method is called from the controller. So I will show you how to call this. So that method, the controller calls this method and checks if you know, there are certain conditions. It checks if the current player, whether the current player is has won or not, is the board full, and nobody has won, then it's a draw. If certain, there is a pattern to the, you know, like the X or the zeros, then it means that particular player has won. So that check happens here. And then there is a rotation which happens, like if the current player is X, the next player should be O, and vice versa. Similarly, in the check win method, so as I said, so it is a, there is a pattern, so it will check whether, you know, whether that pattern is satisfied. If that pattern is satisfied, it will return true. So it will do that for that multi-dimensional array. So that is how it checks and you know, finds out if a player has won or not using this logic here. And then if the board is full, so it will check here. So that is also another method we have written here. So where each cell, it goes through each cell, and if a cell is is empty, then it will return false. If there are no empty cells, then it will return true, which means the board is full. So let's now create a game controller. So go back to your Solution Explorer, right click the controllers, and then add a controller class here. Select empty here and click on add. So game controller, has been added. Now replace this with the code. So this code, what it will do is that it will, as you can see here, the make move method is called here. So this is the make move action method, which is called from the view, and then this controller will call the make move method, which is written inside the game model. So you have to initialize the game model here in top, and once it is initialized, you can access the make move method. And whenever there's a reset, so a reset button will be created in the view, and whenever the user clicks on the reset button, it will create a new instance of game model and then redirect back to the index action method, which is this index action method, and the view will be refreshed, and it will become blank. Basically all the zeros and X will be removed. So let's now create a view. So right click your index method and click on add view. So reserve view empty and click on add, and it will be, by default name will be index.chtml, so we'll keep it as it is. Click on add. Here you can go to Solution Explorer to verify that there a game folder has been created, and within game folder we have the view. So replace this code with this code, and here you can see we are using this model, so there is a reference to this model, and then the title is tic-tac-toe, and then you have some HTML code. So here we have a couple of for loops, so which basically goes through the you know, all the cells in the tic-tac-toe board, and then we have this two-dimensional array, and then we have a button inside that array. So whenever the user clicks on this button, the controller action method will be called. So that will happen, as you can see here, we have a method called as form action, and we have game and make move. So it will go to the game controller and it will search for this make move action method, and it will pass these parameters to the action method. Now we have everything. So we have the code, we have the view, we have the controller class, we have the model class. The next step is to update the program.cs, and here instead of home we want to go to the game. So now by default we'll go to the game index view and the game controller. So let's save this, compile this and run this. So now you can see our view. So the application is now running. So now we can see the application is running, and we can see player X turn here. Let's click on this X. Now next is O, so click on O again, X turn X. Let's click on O and then X. Now player X wins, right? So if you want to start a new game, click on reset game and let's play again. X and O, X, O, X, O. So now player O wins. So let's do a draw. So click on X, O, X, O. Now it's a draw. So I have shown you three scenarios where X wins, O wins, and then it's a draw. So these three scenarios, so that's how you create a game using ASP.NET and C Sharp, and of course our favorite Visual Studio 2022. If you want to enhance this game, we can do it, but please let me know in the comments if you want to see more videos like this, or if you want to enhance and you know, add more things like score and other things, then that can also, we can do that. So I can show you how to do that, but please let me know in the comments, and please like the video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.